And now, ladies and gentlemen, here are the St. Louis Ambush. They're led by their goalkeeper, number 17, Paolo. Forward number 2, Tony Walls, former Rochester Rhino. Forward number 20, JT Thomas. Defender number 75, Jonathan Santos. Forward number 86, Otomia. And defender number 95, Felipe Silva. The head coach of the Ambush is Huerton Morera, assisted by Jamie Swanner, Mark Litton, and Otomia Sousa. The equipment manager is Kyle Rudy. Ladies and gentlemen, the St. Louis Ambush. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the video board for a very special announcement from Lancers TV host and Lancer Wall of Famer, Joe Giuliano.
Thanks, Rocky. For the first time since the 2014 and 15 season, the Rochester Lancers take on the St. Louis Ambush. Hi, everybody. I'm Joe Giuliano alongside of Lancers goalkeeper John Savaglia on the call. Tonight, it's Breast Cancer Awareness Night at the Dome Arena. Well, John, both teams falling in their matchups last night, but just a day later, they get a chance to bounce back.
Yeah, absolutely. St. Louis falling another nail-biter to Utica. Rochester losing to Baltimore with some questionable calls from the referees.
Well, for Rochester, the third quarter, they gave up 3 goals, a difficult challenge there. But there were some positives to walk away with.
Absolutely. The defensive shape looked great last night, as well as getting goals on set pieces, which is a big factor in the indoor game.
All right, we'll see what the Lancers bring to the table tonight. St. Louis is in town. Kickoff is next on the Lancers Broadcast Network.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the players' entrance. Join me in welcoming the soul of soccer. Please welcome Soccer Sam.
Thank you, Rocky. Thank you, Rocky Parada, the voice and the Wall of Famer. Thank you, Lancer Dancers.
Hi.
DJ, we got like an issue here. I need a little music. You know that. Come on, let me get in the mood here. I got in the mood. Before I introduce your 2020 Rochester Lancers, please welcome to the field tonight's celebrity captain. She has been part of the Ambush ownership group since the club originated in 2013. She currently is the only female owner of all of MASL indoor soccer in America. Tonight's celebrity captain, one of the owners of the St. Louis Ambush, Shelly Clark. Shelly, come here. Shelly, give me a hug. Oh, thank you. Shelly is one of the people that voted to allow us back in the league, so give her a round of applause. Oh. Tonight's sponsor, Captain, is a huge supporter of your Rochester Lancers. They provide hotels for our out-of-town players, for all our away teams, and for me when I get kicked out of the house. It's been newly renovated, and they're having an absolutely amazing deal for Valentine's Day, so you gotta check this out. They are from the RITN and Conference Center. Please welcome my friends, Tony and Stephanie. Come on out, girls. Oh, I love your hotel, the hot tub, it's just the pool. I almost like getting kicked out of the house. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you so much. And tonight is our pink game. Obviously, we're all wearing pink. After the game, you could win a game-worn jersey that the players are going to be wearing tonight upstairs at our Goal Kick Lounge. Last game, we did a raffle, and some people walked away with a brand-new jersey for $40. So keep that in mind. All the money that is raised tonight goes to the Breast Cancer Coalition of Rochester, New York. The BCCR offers support, programs, and education for those diagnosed with breast cancer, for them and their families. They are an incredible organization that we are so lucky to partner with. Please welcome our honorary captain tonight from the Breast Cancer Coalition of Rochester, Lori. Lori, come on out. You do some beautiful things, Lori. Give me a hug, too. Why not?
Thank you, Lori.
Same here.
Thank you. Tonight, we have another special honorary captain. We have an in-game basket and gift card raffle on the side of the field right over there where the balloons are. Right over there. See over there? All the money raised is going to help a family. Over 100 businesses and families have donated their time and raffle prizes tonight. All money raised will be directly donated to the Lancers Youth Academy family currently battling stage 4 breast cancer. Please welcome tonight's honorary captain, Lisa Tidings. So please, the raffles are over there. A lot of amazing prizes, including game from the Eyed Family of Dealerships, one of those video games. I forgot the name of it, but go check it out. All right, give me some music, brother. Please welcome your Lancers medical staff, our head athletic trainer, Mr. Mike Pilato, our PA, Kyle Mancic, and Wall of Famer, and Jose Belasaca, our team chiropractor. And now your assistant coaches. First, Rochester soccer icon, Mr. Adam Schwartz. Wall of Famers, Mr. John Berardi Curdy, and the American Dream, Mark Soltile. And now your Lancers head coach, also a Wall of Famer, the living legend of Rochester soccer, and the father of Kayla and Callista, our Lancer dancers, Mr. Doug Miller. And tonight's Lancers, the goalies aren't wearing pink, they're wearing black tonight. Goalkeeper number 00 from Hilton, New York, Brian Wilkin. He's making, wait a minute, where's, I need Jilly. He's making his debut back home here in Rochester, New York. He's from Brazil. He played for us and our original team in blue at the Blue Cross Arena last year for M2. With his daughter, Juliana, coming out soon with him. He is goalkeeper number 22 from Brazil, Marcelo Moreira. All right, we had to pass Juli off. Number 2, also from Brazil, Rafa Godoy with Juliana. He wears number 4. He's the Wall of Famer, the pride and joy of Buffalo, New York, making his last tour, Captain Gary Umbelton. Number 7 from Webster, New York, also a Wall of Famer, Diamond Tim Crawford. Wearing number 9 from Spencerport, New York, number Dan Rieger. He wears number 10 from Nottingham, England, YouTube sensation, the captain, Michael Cunningham. Our leading scorer, wearing number 11 from Webster, New York. He's known as the Red Mamba, Captain Anthony Rosano. Second generation pro player here in Rochester, New York. He wears number 13 from Churchill, New York, Frankie Gilberto. He wears number 14 from Rochester, New York, doing the shake there, Alex Harling. He wears number 18 all the way from Cleveland, Ohio, Brian Wolnowski. Making his return to your Lancers all the way from Bosnia, he is the Z-Man wearing number 20, Zikret Osmic. He wears number 21 from Pittsburgh, New York, Matt D'Amico. Wearing number 23 from Philadelphia, PA, also a Wall of Famer, please welcome J.O. Jeremy Ortiz. Wearing number 27 from Peru, Diego the Explorer Mayanga. And from Brighton, New York, number 31, Jeremy Lunko. Back to you, Rocky Parada, the voice.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please remain standing and remove your hats for the singing of our national anthem, this evening being performed by Nick Novellin.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Well, 2 for 2 on the national anthems last night and this evening. Fantastic renditions as we get underway here at the Dome Arena. Hi, everybody. Joe Giuliano along with John Savaglia. Lancers soccer is back as they meet the St. Louis Ambush for the first time since the 2014 and 15 season. John, welcome to the broadcast. Special buzz in the house, breast cancer awareness, the Lancers wearing the pink jerseys, and a lot of great opportunities for the fans tonight to see some good soccer, but also a very special cause being celebrated.
Absolutely. I look around here and I see all these people. It's a great atmosphere right now. The boys look sharp in their pink uniforms. St. Louis has looked sharp their past couple games. The crowd's in for a really, really good game.
The honorary kickoff taking place as the Lancers looking for their first win in 12 this season. Take on St. Louis, who are 6-8. The Ambush coming off a 4-3 win just down the road last night, in or 4-3 loss in Utica Rochester falling last night to Baltimore right here on this same turf, 9-1. Your referee is Chris Penso. Your officials are Chris Penso, Brian Miller, Steve Montanino, and Austin Saney. St. Louis will be in the teal?
Teal, I'd go teal.
Teal jerseys, teal, yep. Black shorts, black socks. Rochester in the pink, as we mentioned, with the white shorts and white socks. Lancers did change their defensive setup. We saw that last night, able to finally break that shell against the Baltimore defense. And as you said in the open, some positives they walked away with.
Absolutely. Rochester switched from going on a man defensively to a 2-3 zone, which, yes, it's going to allow the opposing team to come at them a little bit more, but it's going to take away those passing lanes and those shooting lanes, make St. Louis maybe make an extra pass than they want to, and we can counter.
You're starting keepers for the Rochester Lancers. It'll be Brian Wilkin, his 8th appearance of the season. And Jason Norsich is in the nets, only his 2nd appearance of the season for the St. Louis Ambush. Paolo's
actually in net.
Oh, is it Paolo?
Yep.
Okay, Jason's got the 99.
He's wearing Jason's pants, I believe. He might not have brought an extra pair from the game yesterday.
I didn't see the jersey. I saw the 99 on the pants, and then it is 17, Paolo, who is making his 13th appearance. Thank you, Mr. Savaglia.
I know my keepers. Don't worry, boys, I got you.
Kickoff at midfield. It'll be the Ambush attacking from left to right. Oitomio will do the honors. He's got Thomas with him. Lancers going with Rafa, D'Amico, Gary Boughton, Anthony Rosano, Tim Crawford. As the crowd still filing in, expecting just under 3,000. It'll be standing room only tonight. Oitomio gets the first touch, and we're underway at the Dome Arena in Rochester. Felipe. Lancers in that 2-3 zone. Quick shot, and a good way to start. Routine save for the keeper.
Absolutely, get yourself into the game here.
Oitomio gets there first, gets it to Thomas. Push back into the St. Louis half. Felipe, the 24-year-old, signed after open tryouts in Brazil during the summer of 2018. Everton, the head coach, took a little excursion, found a few crafty Brazilians. And Oitomio going for 2 early shots off the mark.
It's going to be interesting to see how St. Louis comes at this 2-3 zone defensively here. I know Baltimore had a little bit of a problem, but they came out in the second half and figured a way to crack it, so it's going to be interesting to see how St. Louis handles it.
One thing I'm noticing early on is they're not coming as high or as intense with the pressure like Baltimore did yesterday.
Correct, and I think that might actually have to do with the field size that St. Louis plays with. St. Louis plays with a bigger field, because we got D'Amico with the ball and Crawford. St. Louis playing with the bigger field, they might not know really how to play with a smaller field.
Powerful header from D'Amico into the corner. Diego Mayanga battling with Thomas. Here's Mayanga still looking for an opening. Finds it in Alex Harling, the forward who's moved back to his defensive position now. Jeremy Ortiz, top of the arc. A little too heavy on the touch. Lancers have to hustle now, and Diego, what a calm, cool step. Ortiz, left-footed shot off the boards.
Paolo played that really well.
Paolo, the 34-year-old, 10 years of indoor and futsal experience. 68 goals against in 12 games played for the Ambush this season. Da Silva. On to the near side. Duduka. Hard challenge. No call, will play on. Lancers battling. Going to get it forward to Rafa. He would have been gone, but St. Louis coming the other way. Duduka. Dos Santos. Da Silva. The shot. That far side. Tough angle. No trouble there for Brian Wilkin.
It's been a pretty interesting first couple of minutes here. Not really one side taking control of the game. which is nice. I think that's going to play to Rochester's advantage, in my opinion. It's going to let them warm up. It's going to let them get into the game a little bit better.
Now they're coming a little higher with the pressure. St. Louis comes at Wilkin, but the Lancers in Rieger. Jahic comes away with it. A little tug on the shoulder. It's Rieger called for the foul. Restart for Dos Santos. Is it quickly to Santos. Dos Santos to Santos. One Santos to two Santos. Shot, good block there. Dos Santos. Stefan St. Louis, what a great name.
I know, it was good.
Good hockey name.
Good hockey name, and I guess when you play for St. Louis, it's great to have a name like that too.
I'd say that's appropriate. Shot through the legs of Wilkin. And Scharf opens the scoring with his third goal of the year.
It's a good shot. It's good. It's good composure in front of the net there. Trying to make a move to make Brian go down. And got Brian to go down and open his legs a little.
3:07, fourth goal of the year for Scharf.
Good turn. It's going to be interesting to see how Rochester responds after giving up that goal. This is the first goal they've given up that early in the past couple games here.
Jahic with the assist, his first points of the season. 3:07 time of the St. Louis goal. Last weekend, Rochester played in Milwaukee, Kansas City. We'll talk about that in a second. Itomio, saved by Wilkin. The Lancers scored the first goal in those two games. Last night, giving up the first one to Baltimore. And it was the third quarter that three goals were given up and kind of changed the complexion of that game.
Yeah, and if we look how Rochester has been playing, it's been the, you know, if we look at the chance again, or the goal here. Good touch, good finish. But Rochester plays really well in the first two quarters, and then coming out of halftime, I think that's just the solution they're trying to look for is how to get past those 3 and 4.
Foul on the near side boards. Be a restart for the Lancers. Harling now with it. Back to Wilkin, 11:08 left. First quarter, 1-0, St. Louis with the lead, high pressure. San Luis, the veteran battling with Jeremy Ortiz. Still Ortiz, double team now in the corner.
Really well done to get
good
that away.
Good job, and not an easy way to get out of there. Chance for Boughton on the sprint, two in front. Can he turn the corner? Itomio is there. And San Luis helps out. St. Louis still, though, pinned in their own half. Chance here for D'Amico. Rafa, all the way back to Crawford. Lancers against pulling the trigger there. We'll regroup.
Group get a few fresh legs out there.
Diego. Off the boards. Answers with some pressure here. Loose ball in front for Crawford. Couldn't get a foot on it. Rosano. Left-footed shot off the boards. Back into the mix. St. Louis.
Great pressure for
good
Rochester.
Good pressure. Winning the ball back. Consistent attack here from the home side. Good shift for Mayanga. Crawford. Cunningham. Gary Boughton. And Rosano on it now. There's Wilkin, pride and joy of the Hilton Cadets. D'Amico battling with Dos Santos. Cunningham will take it back for Rochester. Long shift for Mayanga, Cunningham, Rosano. Those two will step off. Fresh legs hopping on for Doug Miller's side. Paolo to Santos. We'll get those Santos boys figured out here tonight. This one gets through under the foot of Kozakov and blasted up. And this is going to come to the top of the arc in a dangerous restart situation.
I thought maybe it got deflected, but it's going too fast for me to really make a judgment on that.
Brian Wilkins sets up his wall. Dangerous restart here for the visitors. Dudica, Itomio! gets his goal, and they're going to call a yellow card as well. And some insult to injury.
I think that's going to go to Ortiz on the challenge.
And for Otoimio, his second of the season. Deduca will get the assist. Restarts, you see it all the time. So crucial.
I'll play it, yep.
Great touch.
Well, I don't know where the foul is in there.
Joel, can we see that again? 5:53 time of the goal. Descent is what they're calling on the field. Step over. Deduca.
Okay.
Interesting.
Yep, I see. J.O. got a little angry with the refs after that, so I do see the descent card. I was thinking maybe it was on the tackle.
And that could have been from the initial call with the ball going up into the crowd.
Yeah.
Where you thought maybe it was deflected.
And that's one thing Rochester's going to have to do is try and stay composed tonight. I know yesterday was a little frustrating. It's going to try and stay composed. It's a new game, new day.
De Silva. Kozakov. Deduca back to De Silva.
And I just want to mention to everybody, there is no power play for a yellow card. I know the power play is on the screen right here with 4 minutes and 29 seconds left, but there is no power play for a yellow card.
Yeah, there's no contact there, but yeah, you can see Ortiz looking towards the official. And he wasted no time pulling out the yellow card. Rafa leaves it for Crawford. Into the corner.
Good
Kick save.
Save
from Paolo. Diego. Good save again from Paolo.
Good hold by Paolo not to give up a rebound as Frankie was right there waiting for it.
Paolo in his third year with the Ambush. It's to Stefan Saint-Louis, his ninth year of indoor soccer. He's been everywhere, Detroit, Missouri, Milwaukee. Now making his home with the Ambush. Santos. Saint-Louis. Rosano, good steal. Rieger, toe poke forward. Wolanski steps to his left. The shot off the mark. Picked up by Rieger. Double team, nowhere to go.
That's great work for St. Louis to get back and help out Paolo and help out, you know, the defenders.
Jahic escapes one challenge. Still Jahic. Ooh, through the box and no one there to poke it home. A little bit of an easy tap in. St. Louis works it around the horn again. Shot. Good deflection, and Wilkins got to quickly come scoop it up. Driven throw downfield. Picked back the other way now.
Great
good steal by Mayanga. He's been solid early on. 7:08 left. Lancers trailing 2-0. Nice ball. D'Amico looking for help. Three of them marking the shot.
Good run
off
from
the
Gary.
Mark from Gary, still in play here. Top of the arc. D'Amico to Alex Harling. Rafa. Been known to tee it up once in a while. Goes to Gary. The farewell tour of Gary Boughton. Still Boughton shot. High and off the mark. 6:39 left in the first quarter. St. Louis has a 2-0 lead. This is the Lancers Broadcast Network. Welcome back. Lancers trailing the St. Louis Ambush by a score of 2-0.
All right. I want to give a little shout out in St. Louis for an Ambush watch party at the Post Sports Bar, just a few miles from the Family Arena. Thanks for joining us tonight.
They sent a picture of the watch party and a very good crowd there at the Post Sports Bar.
Absolutely. It looks like a ball. I wish I was over there. Unfortunately, I'd be wearing Lancers gear. I don't know how they'd welcome me, but.
It's the Midwest. Very friendly.
Absolutely.
Enjoying our coverage, hopefully. Out in St. Louis, your home side with a 2-0 lead as we're back underway here in the first quarter. Paolo. Oh, what a
what
goal!
Woo!
What a goal from Frankie Ciliberto! You've got to be kidding me.
SportsCenter, are you watching?
On the bicycle kick, Frankie Siliberto explodes for his second goal of the year. Sensational.
Are you kidding me? Frankie, well done. Well deserved.
Take a look.
Oh, my word. We're going to need to save a clip of that and send it into SportsCenter.
Oh, my word. Play of the week in the MASL and SportsCenter. Harling with the ball in. What a finish from Frankie Siliberto, the 22-year-old. Sensational.
And you could hear the crowd erupt here.
Woo!
Wow.
What a goal. This place is ready to explode. The Lancers can get another one here. Keep their composure. Feel this momentum. What a goal from Frankie Siliberto. I just mentioned to his uncle, Roger, before the game. I said, hey, your nephew Frankie's playing very well. Nodded his head, said, yep, and look what he comes up with tonight. Beautiful. Here's Rosano. There's Frankie again. Oh, he is feeling it. Cunningham. Why not, Michael? Feel the magic.
Absolutely. You got the crowd behind you. We look at it again. Oh.
My word.
That's breathtaking right there.
I'm going to catch my breath just for a second.
Oh.
Woo.
I don't blame you.
That is the magic of the indoor game that Sam continues to talk about. And St. Louis coming right back with Oitomio.
I must give you credit. How long did you spend trying to learn these last names for St. Louis here?
Started on Monday.
You are doing a fantastic job.
I'm trying. If I did mispronounce some of them, I apologize to our good friends in St. Louis. Good ball from Rafa. Rosano looking for his seventh of the year. He'll slow it up to Diego. Harling. Rafa. Mayanga. Alex Harling. Well, good anticipation. Wilkin into the corner. D'Amico. Little back flick to Paolo. Comes onto the near side looking for Dos Santos. Given away, coming forward, the shot, and it's wide off the mark by Kozakov. Lancers dodge a bullet there. Miko got around one, couldn't get past St. Louis. St. Louis having some trouble coming out of their own half now. Dealing with the Lancers' pressure. 4 minutes left. Very entertaining first quarter.
Absolutely. It's been a very good first quarter for both sides, in my opinion.
Pablo da Silva. San Luis. Pablo. St. Louis is going to slow things down, try to take away some of this energy after that bicycle kick goal. Liberto's touch finds Boughton, spins away from pressure. Back to his keeper. Seesaw battle. Teams applying pressure, looking for that one mistake.
Yep.
Who will pay the price?
I don't really know which side that'll play for here. I know Rochester's good on the counter, but St. Louis has been playing really well defensively.
Lewis peppering the Lancers net. Rieger trying to streak forward. Nudged off the ball by his number nine counterpart, San Luis. Jonathan Santos, the 35-year-old, coming over at the beginning of January when a trade with Milwaukee. Goes to the far side. Good touch. And a good block from Diego Mayanga.
Great block.
Tomio taking that shot.
And Jeremy is back on the field after serving his yellow card penalty.
Five-minute break for Jeremy.
Nothing wrong with that. Gotta catch your breath.
Bobadilla to San Luis. Shot doesn't get through.
Oh.
Whoa.
Paolo did really well to deal with that.
Not easy, huh? Jeremy, a little touch too much. Lancers home again. Friday, February 21st. Saturday, February 22nd. Friendly confines at the Dome Arena. Hey, Tomio. Good move. Still. Shot. Through the mix and tapped into the net by Bobadilla.
I was just about to say something about St. Louis. If you watch how they move the ball around, they always have one player running to the back post.
And Bobadilla getting a nice celebration for his first goal of the year at 13:08. Tomio with the assist.
Rochester's going to have to aware if we look at it here again. Good fake. And good just cross. You got two wide open on the back post there.
Yeah. That could have been Bobadilla or it could have been Duarte to put that easily into the net.
Absolutely, and that's something that the Lancers are going to have to pay attention to going forward here is that make sure that back post is covered.
St. Louis responding. Make it 3-1. Bobadilla, the 26-year-old. Former U.S. futsal player. Also has some experience with Cedar Rapids. Gets his first of the year. Rosano. Hustling to keep it is Boughton. Back to Wilkin. Long shot there from Thomas. Saw that Wilkin was off his line. Not a bad choice.
No, not at all. Wonder if his eyes got really big.
Tony Walls, have not called his name tonight, but he's having an outstanding season. 15 goals, 7 assists for the former Rochester Rhino. Cunningham.
Good save.
Good save at the near post. A driven ball from Cunningham, who's getting closer to the mark.
All it takes is one. Sometimes it's not a pretty goal either, but.
Final minute of play in the first quarter. Pablo. Back to Paolo. Jahic for Felipe. Scharf, one of the goal scorers tonight, opened the scoring at 3:07. St. Louis looking to knock it around, maybe one more push in the final few seconds here. Paolo. 16 seconds, all the way up to midfield. Paolo, 10 seconds. St. Louis will put the
great
touch
save.
Forward shot and a good poke save there from Wilkin, wasn't it?
Well played.
5.8 seconds, corner kick here for the visitors. Lancers Walls backed up. Oh, what a finish. It's Thomas.
Great finish.
Gets the service from Santos.
Good composure there to take that rollover after the pass and not hit it one time.
JT Thomas, his 16th goal of the year at 14:57. St. Louis stretches this out now to a 4-1 lead.
Take a look at it again here. It's a great first touch and just roofs it.
Is that Pablo or Thomas? I couldn't tell.
I couldn't tell from there.
Well, they're going to call Pablo with the goal, excuse me. Thomas, you're still at 15 goals.
Take a look at it again here.
It is Pablo.
Pablo, yeah. And just
roofs Pablo's
it.
Got his third of the year. Lancers trailing 4-1.
That'll end it.
After one quarter of play, Pablo's goal with 3 seconds left off the corner kick giving St. Louis a 3-goal lead. We'll take a break. This is the Lancers Broadcast Network. Welcome back to the Dome Arena. Joe Giuliano along with John Savaglia as the Rochester Lancers trailing St. Louis Ambush by a score of 4-1. But as we go back to that first quarter, 8:37, what a goal from Frankie Siliberto. In the first quarter, Paolo.
Great touch from Alex Harling. And I don't even know a word that can describe that. That's just...
The high pressure from the Lancers forcing a poor giveaway. And Harling, just a quick little touch, and Frankie Siliberto seals it with a little bit of magic. Here's another look at it. What a goal.
Such a great goal.
Beautiful.
Such a
beautiful
great goal.
Finish.
Now here's the thing that Rochester needs to be aware of. It is 4-1. Game is still within reach. Calm down. Do what you did before, put St. Louis under pressure. We see how powerful St. Louis is when they come at us and have control in our zone. They're looking for that back post ball. Make sure that back post is covered.
Second quarter underway, Lancers looking to get a little closer here for a dynamite goal from Frankie Siliberto. Just making sure we're clear, in the first quarter that goal did come from Pablo at the end, not JT Thomas. It was Pablo with that goal.
You know, one thing I'm watching right now is St. Louis is giving back some interesting balls to their goalkeeper here.
Yeah, they've done no favors, have they?
Yeah. And Paolo has done very well to control those balls given back to him.
I think when you've got a guy with that much experience,
they trust him.
Yeah, you trust him. And, you know, maybe your touch is a little looser than normal.
Right.
This is top of the arc. They got one last night against Baltimore. Ortiz with Rosano. Here it is.
Oh, great block.
Handball.
Call for a hand. Yep, they got it. They got it.
They're going to call the handball on Duarte, I believe. He's claiming no, it hit my thigh. And the blue card is out. Duarte will go to the box. And the Lancers will go to the power play.
And is this just going to be a set piece here, or are we going to have a penalty shot because it was a goal scoring opportunity?
It's going to be a restart at the point of the foul. See Duarte pleading his case.
Absolutely. I would plead my case as well. I mean, throwing your body at it, you know, you're not really trying to play the ball with your hands. However, it does hit your hand.
All right, Lancers have a power play opportunity with the man advantage. Rochester 15% clip. The PK for St. Louis, 44%. Ortiz and Rosano, the architects again.
Great block.
Another good block that time from Santos. Lancers will start the man advantage. Boughton, huge opportunity to claw your way back into this one.
Especially early in the second quarter. Gives you a chance to set the tone.
Boughton. Mayanga. Answers working, looking for an opening. Boughton thought about a shot. Holds up, gets it to Rosano. Will their piercing diagonal ball come into play? Let's see.
Oh, great. Great fake.
Yeah, nice composure by Anthony.
Learned a little something from St. Louis playbook there.
Mayanga, that's the ball to break things up. There it is, Rosano, tees it up. Good shot. Mayanga tried the deflection, couldn't get it. Lancers will still keep it, though. Good job.
Great work.
1 minute left in the man advantage.
St. Louis is doing a very, very good job as well, taking away those passing lanes and those shooting lanes. Seen a couple blocks here.
Mayanga. Rafa. Yeah, very good defensive shape here by the ambush.
And they're switching it up. They're going with a diamond formation, and they're going with like a box-type formation, keeping Rochester on their toes.
Rafa. Jeremy. Ortiz, good shot.
Another
good
great block.
Yep.
It's a great penalty kill from St. Louis.
22 seconds left. Rosano, 15 seconds left. Pulls it back. Final moments of the man advantage. Rafa into the corner. Boughton gets a second touch on it. Paolo makes the save.
Very well. Come off his line and grab that. Be careful of the guy breaking.
Well coached defensively by Everton. The indoor player with 15 years experience, the Brazilian now behind the bench for the St. Louis ambush.
Absolutely. Very well disciplined back there.
St. Louis will catch their breath after killing off that penalty. Waitomio. Holding, looking. This is Thomas.
Great
good block.
Block
from Crawford, and Thomas's second shot is up and into the netting. Well, the ambush, 6-8 on the season. They've had some nail biters, no doubt about it. Three of their six wins in overtime, and every win, each of their six wins by one goal.
Yeah, and a couple of those came when they were behind big. They were down 5-1. The one game I watched was the Utica game. They were down 5-1. They came back, and they won in a shootout. So St. Louis doesn't go away. Doesn't matter what the score is. Great chance.
Oh,
great goal.
Yes! Michael Cunningham! Well done, my friend. Well done.
Taking the signature sip of tea. Cunningham, well-deserved. Great goal.
His fourth of the season. And we talked about it. His shots are getting closer. It's coming. It's coming. And we see it here.
Right. And here's the pressure again from Rochester. Forces a bad ball, a bad giveaway, and a finish. And hopefully that's the one that just opens up the floodgates for Cunningham.
Well done, Mr. Cunningham. Fourth of the year at 3:36. And it's the second one forced by a giveaway. And we talked about this, John. Earlier in the season, the Lancers were always getting punished for their mistakes. Now we're slowly seeing a little shift towards the Lancers making the opposition pay.
Absolutely, and we look at the halfway point of the season here. Rochester has their first 12 games under their belt now. They're starting to learn this indoor game. And now those mistakes that they are making are fewer and fewer, and the chances that they're creating from their opponent's mistakes are starting to increase.
Tonight's the first time I've seen Rochester make the opposition pay for any sort of mistakes. Good sign.
Absolutely, and hopefully that's going to be the talk at halftime, is just keep throwing the pressure at St. Louis.
Give it away, two on
they
two.
Again.
If they hurry, D'Amico shot off the boards in front. Nobody in pink sitting there.
Oh, Rafa.
Cheeky little slide there, almost poked it in. Rosado, good look, shot!
Great save.
Right at Paolo, shifting it the whole way.
Well done. I know it was a little critical in the beginning talking about St. Louis, not knowing how to play with a smaller field. They have definitely been able to pull that, you know, together, throwing the pressure at us.
There's Tony Walls.
Great movement.
Bomb of a shot from the former Rochester Rhino. Standout player, Tony Walls, in the outdoor game. Very popular here with the Rhinos fans. The 29-year-old. He's in Rochester from 2014 to 2016, has the ball now.
If you watch the way St. Louis moves the ball, there's not a lot of movement with the players. They'll pass the ball, and it looks like they just stay in one spot, and they'll just keep moving it around to spread out the defense. Here's the goal once again from Cunningham, right between the wickets.
Wilkin rifles it downfield. Lancers have it on the near side. Wolanski, or it's Siliberto, who knocks it off of Santos. Good opportunity here to start it up from the near side boards.
Another set piece.
9:06 left in the second quarter. We have that opportunity here. Good ball in front, but it's blocked. Wilkin.
Good move.
Blanco, what a great move along the boards to open up some space.
Great composure.
Blanco back to Wilkin. Siliberto looking for more. In front, Boughton shot. Good save
from
Paolo.
Great save from Paolo, making himself big. Nice. Sacrificing.
Good shot from Rafa. Boughton gets it to settle. Finds Crawford. Godoy. Almost midway point of the second quarter. Mayanga avoids Bobadilla. Cunningham has to quickly scoop that back into possession for Harling. He's pickpocketed, but hustles back, battling with Walls on the near side.
Watch the back post there.
Oh, good job, Mayanga.
Well done.
Didn't bite, kept possession, or kept the offensive player.
Looks like a foul on St. Louis. I can't tell from this.
Yep, it'll be a restart for the Lancers, 7:50. Be sure to check out the MASL podcast. It returns for this season. Join us as we talk to players, officials, and coaches from across the league and take you behind the scenes of the MASL. Check out MASLsoccer.com to listen to past episodes, the official MASL podcast on Apple Podcasts. Cunningham.
Great defensive work.
Nice work from Thomas.
Great defensive work from
Thomas.
Gives
it away. Harling. Aggressive and off his line is Wilkin. Santos. Pressures back to Paolo. Just past the midway point. Another giveaway here. Rafa to Diego. Rafa's shot. Paolo's got to be aware. D'Amico's knocking on the door. Totally different complexion to this one.
Absolutely.
Mistakes are leading to Lancer opportunities.
Just seems like a different atmosphere down there for them tonight.
Absolutely. Deflected, loose ball.
Well,
what a save
from
Brian Wilkin.
That is well done. Stick with it. Put his body on the line. Fantastic save.
4-2, and we'll go to break on a tremendous save from Brian Wilkin. This is the Lancers Broadcast Network. Thank you.
Back to You Market and Lancer Lessons T-shirts is T-shirt time.
Four, two, St. Louis leading. Joe Giuliano with Johnny One Arm Savaglia. Your thoughts so far?
Really, really well
you
done.
You don't like that name, do you?
No, I like it. Okay. It's going to be interesting next year when I'm back in the net and they're calling me One Arm.
Hey,
but
might stick.
Hey, but anyways, great, great first half of that quarter from both teams. As we looked at the save again from Brian right there, you know, Rochester capitalizing on some mistakes, but St. Louis putting the pressure with the veterans.
All right, 6:43. Here we go, second quarter. Header back to Paolo. Oh. He has some trouble with it. Paolo to Pablo. Way to Mio. He's so crafty on the ball.
I know.
Ortiz, a little shove.
Yes, shove there, but I like how Rochester's being a little physical. When you're 0-12, you got to set the tempo, set the mood, say, hey, just because we're 0-12 doesn't mean we're not going to put up a fight.
Yep. I agree, my friend. Restart by St. Louis. St. Louis under pressure. Boughton will get there first. Bang it off the boards. Ortiz, Rafa pops it in the air. Pablo. Leitomio. To Felipe. St. Louis got a look and a block from Ortiz.
And here comes Rochester.
Two on two. D'Amico gets around one.
Yeah.
D'Amico off the boards and through the goal! Jeremy Ortiz!
What a play from Frankie. Throw it at the net and good things will happen. Wow.
Number four for Jeremy Ortiz.
We have got a game, folks.
Lancers within one. Frankie Siliberto with the assist. He is having a night.
Look at it again here. Great run from Frankie. Rip a shot off the boards. Jeremy, great composure to take that one time and place it where Paolo isn't.
4-3 your score. Ortiz is fifth of the season. Siliberto's third assist of this season. Frankie's got one goal, one assist tonight. As the souvenir ball goes into the crowd. And the Lancers, they're coming. We've seen this before. They chop away at the lead. And then they let the opposition in again. We'll see if that changes tonight.
Absolutely. And that's one thing, Rochester's going to have to stay composed. But there is a different feel to this game than the other games, in my opinion.
Kozakov, a 26-year-old, fourth year in the MASL. Wilkin denying at the near post.
Play top of the box here.
Don't like these. We don't like these going this way.
Look again here. Oh, that's a great finish from Jeremy. That ball coming off those boards.
Not easy. Wall shot.
Great block from D'Amico.
D'Amico's been solid tonight. He has worked so hard. Mayanga, Paolo off his line. He'll get there first. Chance for Thomas. The shot is wide. Another shot. What a swerving shot.
What a strike.
And it's put home by Otoimio.
What a strike. Little flossing there. Remember, always floss after every meal. But that was a fantastic strike. Oh,
that's his third of the season, second of the game.
And that just reminds Rochester, hey, we're still here. Just because you scored a couple unanswered doesn't mean we're going away.
And we just talked about that, though. They come, we get close, and then there's these breakdowns
yep.
that open the door once again.
And that's just, this is just a great finish. My hat's off there. That's just a fantastic finish. But you are correct. We have talked about that. And that's something that Rochester's going to have to figure out.
Otoimio, his third of the season. He's got two goals, one assist, and the Lancers are going to have a little visitor to the box. That's a classy goal.
That's a classy goal, and I think that yellow card's for Rosano after the play there, kicking the ball down the field.
Anthony Rosano has been given a yellow card, five-minute penalty, so he'll sit out the remaining 5 minutes of the quarter. Rochester will not be shorthanded. Not sure if it's for dissent or if you get the call from our PA announcer, but we'll try to get that for you here. But it's a five-minute yellow card to the Lancers, and look at that tackle.
Yep, there's the blue card right there.
Open the door. Okay, severe unsportsmanlike conduct to Rosano for that penalty, or for that infraction.
And then right here, Rochester is going.
Who is in the box for St. Louis?
Should be on the power play here.
Cunningham shot, blocked.
I don't understand.
Let's see if we can get clarification from field level that blue card was shown. Hard challenge in the corner by Douglas Dos Santos. Maybe they pulled it back.
Great play from Jeremy right there, Jeremy Lanco. Great move from Jeremy Ortiz.
Yep, 5-on-5 still.
And I think after this weekend of games, we need to get the 50-page rule book, not just the Spark Notes version of the rule book. I think
Ryan
we need
Miller sent me a PDF about 5 minutes before the game, so I'll try to research it. So it was a warning issued for their fourth delay of game. Walls is tripped up, or it's Santos, I'm sorry. 4:04 left. I thought I saw the blue card come out.
I thought I did too.
My glasses are.
This is the strike again.
Tucked away.
Oh, you placed that perfect. Place that perfect.
Restart on the near side. Felipe. San Luis. Back to Felipe. Felipe, middle of the park.
Great movement from St. Louis.
San Luis, another one
going for that corner
again. Swerving shots. They're seeing something they like there.
That's the only place a keeper can't get the ball.
Another good save from Wilk. We saw last night Baltimore hit, I think, one or two maybe like that where there was a couple of swerves.
A little curve. A little bend it like Beckham action.
Yes, absolutely. Answers coming back with their bit of high pressure. 3:15 left in the first half, trailing 5-3.
There's the high pressure and another
giveaway
from St. Louis.
Giveaway back the other way. Shot and a goal. Kozakov making the Lancers pay for some sloppy work out of the back. And for Kozakov, his third of the year.
Yeah, we talked about the giveaway from Paolo there. Unfortunately, you know, Brian only had one defender with him, and I'm not exactly sure who that was. But St. Louis came right back with three. So take a look at it here. It looks like it's Jeremy Lanco was back. And in my opinion, that's the right play from Brian. You got to play it off the boards, nowhere else to go. But St. Louis does a very good job of making them pay, and we talked about that with the mistakes.
Unassisted goal. That one from Kozakov. Lancers now need to get back to work. They were within one, trailing now by three with 2:48 left in this second quarter.
Positive, they were down at three at one point, so it is possible.
A little too heavy on the Service downfield from Brian Wilkin. 2:38 left. First half action at the Dome Arena. Harling pressured by Scharf. Pastor Ortiz, Siliberto will get it though. Frankie with a goal and an assist tonight.
Now play on.
Yep.
Play on, says the ref.
Bobadilla goes down. We move on with Diego Mayanga. Just over 2 minutes left.
St. Louis applying the high pressure now, going man-to-man zone.
Wilkin downfield.
Oh, turf monster.
A little seam there. You can see it opened up just a bit. We've got Mayanga. Wilkin comes out, gets some help there from Timmy Crawford. And Timmy comes away with the ball, wide open, Lanco.
Here.
Heavy touch from Lanco, Rieger will take it. Just couldn't keep it clean. Answers are gonna start again, 1:30 left. Diego.
Get a couple changes here.
Couple changes, one more push, maybe squeak in a fourth and get to that dressing room and regroup. Wilkin. Forced to go all the way back once again. All right. The goal scorer, Jeremy Ortiz, drives one down into the near corner, three-line pass.
Three-line pass.
Restart coming up now at the yellow line, dangerous.
I think there's talking from Jeremy there, see maybe it took a deflection or if it maybe hit the turf.
1:03 left. Well, with 3 seconds left, St. Louis on a restart in the first quarter, buried one. We'll see what they do here at 63 seconds. Pablo, shot, and it's in!
Deflected off D'Amico, I think.
Pablo will get the assist, but and the goal is going to go to Duduka.
Duduka with a powerful shot. Powerful shot. I heard that from up here, and I have headphones on.
And 13th of the year for the big man.
Jeremy needs to be careful here, talking to the ref again.
One goal, one assist,
look
and here's a
it.
Look at it.
Pablo and, wow, just a deflection from D'Amico. Unlucky.
Pablo with a goal and an assist tonight. That's his sixth assist of the season. 7-3, Rochester has it all to do again. Final minute of play here. It's gonna be a battle to stay positive and just keep fighting.
Absolutely.
So close, but yet, so far.
Yep, and that's still expected with how young the Lancers yep. are. And if there's one person that can get the Lancers back on track, it's our coach.
It's the process.
It's definitely the process as well.
Pieces of this process.
Yep. And it, you see, you know, St. Louis has made some mistakes, and we've capitalized on that, and that's, you know, that's a positive. Unfortunately, we make some mistakes, and St. Louis will capitalize on us, and that's just the veteran presence for St. Louis.
It's gone back and forth tonight. Final 10 seconds here.
Oh.
Oh, they're going to call the advantage. Let's see. We'll play on.
We'll play on here.
Okay. There is going to be a penalty.
And that
should
be.
As soon as St. Louis touches it. 2.1 seconds left. St. Yep. Louis will go to the box, and the Lancers now, man advantage.
Here's the thing. Yesterday, we had the same exact situation. Rochester getting a power play right before halftime. You're going into halftime with about a minute 58. You can set up a play here and dictate how that second half starts.
So St. Louis is on the bench. He's not in the box. John, this one's on you, buddy. The blue card was held up.
I'm confused. And granted, I know I am a little colorblind, but I'm pretty sure I saw blue.
I agree with you.
Okay, so good. It's not just me. But
officials tonight, just so you know, are Chris Pencil, Brian Miller, Steve Montanino, and Austin
well,
Sadie.
I'm sure when Brian re-listens to this cast here, he is very good at letting us know exactly, you know, what the call is.
Okay, now they'll go over to the Lancers bench and hopefully explain. The door is open. St. Louis being sent over to the
there
sin bin.
Okay.
All right, little clarification, and it's all sorted out.
Yeah, and I know last night we were a little critical of some of the calls, but we do know that the refs have a very, very hard job out there.
Tough pace
and
to keep up with.
I wouldn't want to do it, I can tell you that for sure.
Good to see, though, they took their time.
Yep.
Pencil and Miller, the officials, and they cleaned it up. As
it's not a bad option.
1 second left.
Yeah, I mean, not a bad option there. Throw it at net. Good things happen. And I'll just chuck it down the field, and that's that.
That will bring our first half to a close as the Lancers have a big battle ahead of them in the final two quarters. They trail 7-3 against the St. Louis Ambush. We'll keep it here and go down to field level. Soccer Sam or Ashley will have our halftime interview. Lancers with goals from Cunningham and Ortiz in this second quarter. And Soccer Sam, take it away.
Once again, nice. Fans, want to remind you, you can head down to the area under the scoreboard for tonight's basket raffle. Plenty of time to get your tickets. Head down now. And now, ladies and gentlemen, he is ready to go. He's always ready. He is the soul of soccer. One more time, let's hear it for Soccer Sam.
Thank you, Rocky. Frankie Ciliberto, Ciliberto, the right way to say it. Frankie, baby. That goal that you scored today, it's going to be on ESPN highlights. Every news channel is going to carry it. It's probably the prettiest goal in the history of Lancers soccer. Let's hear it from Frankie Ciliberto. Frankie, baby, we got it. They just showed a goal. Baby, what's going through your head when you're ready to do the bicycle?
Man, I mean, I couldn't think. Those are some of the things that you just practice, just messing around in the backyard. You never get the opportunity in a game to usually do that, but came to me and went up for it, and fortunately it went in.
So today we had a big tournament here, hundreds of kids, including kids from Churchville. Your coaches are here when you were a kid. Your high school coaches are here. This is a big night for you here tonight.
Yeah, it means a lot seeing my coaches from high school come out and support. It's been a while since I've been in high school, but yeah, I love the support, and I love playing in Rochester.
Well, I tell you, we are proud that you are Rochester born and raised, and this is what this team's all about. We're developing local talent so all these young kids have a place, a home to come back to when they're done with college and play professionally. Thank you so much, Frankie.
Thank you too, Sam.
Frankie Ciliberto. Tony Walls, come here, Tony. We got Tony Walls here. All the people in St. Louis, Tony, right now, they are in some bar celebrating you guys up right now. You guys are up 7-3. And Tony, this is big tonight.
Yeah, I mean, it feels good to be back in Rochester. I mean, you guys have a good team, a great setup. We knew it wasn't going to be an easy game. You know, fortunate to get some goals. But we got to keep going because I know you guys aren't going to quit. So,
former Rhino player, Tony, I love Walls. You've been playing indoor soccer for how many years, Tony?
It's my eighth season.
Eighth season playing indoor professional soccer. And I hear you're going to the USL?
Yeah, Pittsburgh, back with Bob Lilly.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Leading scorer for your St. Louis Ambush. Say hello to all the people in St. Louis that are watching right now.
St. Louis, we love you. Rochester fans, we love you also.
All right, Tony Walls. He's a good guy. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, it's time for the world famous Lanza Dancers.
Oh, Tom. All right, Soccer Sam, thank you very much. At the half, it's St. Louis leading the Lancers 7-3. We will throw it down to field level, take a short break, come back with more coverage right here on the Lancers Broadcast Network.
And welcome back to MASL Primetime.
The team of the week, Vinny Dantas, Leo Gibson, Gustavo Rosales, Evan McNeely, Drew Ruggles of the Florida Tropics, and goalkeeper William Abanahani. And the primetime player of the week brought to you by Sports Turf. And it's Leo Gibson, and you can understand why. He only played a single game against Rochester, but Leo was massive. 7 points in the one game, 6 goals as Leo helped him to the win, and he continues to lead the MASL scoring race. Primetime plays of the week. And starting with number 5, St. Louis against Orlando. Look at the Ambush passing. Tic-tac-toe. Dudica Carvalho with the finish. Number four, Michael Ramos for Tacoma against Monterey just murders the poor miter ball. And that was the game winner. Drew Ruggles making mincemeat of St. Louis, the dynamite solo rush and the finish. Number two, the top three actually were all fantastic solo runs. Tavoy Morgan of Harrisburg turns Baltimore inside out and then finally beats keeper William Van Zyla. We thought this one topped them all though. Mesquite's Jorge De Leon against Monterey. I mean, he covers some serious real estate and then provides the big finish. Gorgeous. And that is our primetime play of the week. Yeah, we're all out of time for today, but just a reminder, MASLsoccer.com is your home base for all things in the Major Arena Soccer League, and there's all kinds of other social media to keep you up to date as well. Thank you so much for watching MASL Primetime, and we'll see you next week. Yeah.
correct to do this, but we're going to have the Lancer dancers spread out and girls move around. We're going to do something we've never done before. DJ Keo, I need some Valentine's Day love music because Valentine's Day is February 14th. It's a couple weeks away, and we've never done this before, but the Lancer dancers are going to give all our fans a kiss.
A kiss, Dr. Sammy? Is that appropriate?
Probably not appropriate, but if you receive a bag of kisses, please share them with the people in your aisle. Let's give us some music, DJ Keel. Let's do it, brother.
All right, halftime festivities still continuing here at the Dome Arena. St. Louis with a 7-3 lead over the Rochester Lancers. Well, the home side came within one, but St. Louis jumped up once again to take a 7-3 lead. Joe Giuliano along with John Savaglia here at the Dome Arena as we look at some stats from across the MASL. Looking at your standings, these are not including last night's game. If you look at Florida, tremendous season. They're 11-1 after 12 games played. Milwaukee right behind them at 8-3. Utica also jumps up to a tie for second place, 8-3. The goal differential will be the big tiebreaker there. But John, top four teams in each conference advance to the playoffs. Seeing a little bit of a log jam here.
Yeah, and this is a big game for St. Louis. I know they're right now in the bottom three, but a win here skyrocket them up a little bit back into playoff contention.
Shifting over to the Western Conference, conference that we don't see too much of or have too much experience with, but in the Western Conference, Monterey, what a season they are having. They're 14-1. San Diego Soccer's the legendary soccer club just behind them at 9-2, but then good battle for that third, fourth spot in the West.
Yeah, I was going to say, they're about the same place that the East is in, a little bit of a log jam there for the final two spots. I'm assuming Monterey and San Diego, you know, are going to take those first two spots there.
And statistically, looking at some of the leaders in the MASL, some goal scorers, and Frank, what did I tell you? 25 goals leading the MASL. Ian Bennett right there with 23. Aguilar, Gibson with 22. Francis and Canet with 21. Points leaders overall, Leo Gibson with 38. A little bit of a gap there between Gibson and the following five players who are stuck on the 30 mark. Leo Gibson top of the points. Assists, Max Ferdinand, talented indoor player with the Milwaukee Wave. One better than Leo Gibson, Nick Pereira, and Ricardo Carvalho as your MASL assist leaders. Goals against, Hugo Silva, top keeper. It's a pretty impressive number for indoor soccer.
Absolutely. For a 3.42 goals against average, that's fantastic. And plays for Florida, explains why they're top in the East.
Who's up there? Will the Wall.
Will the Wall, local Rochester player. He's had a fantastic season as well.
Rafa Diaz, Andrew Coughlin, Boris Pardo. And the man we saw last night, William Van Zella, rounding out your goals against leaders in the MASL. Save percentage, our boy from Rochester, New York, Will the Wall Benahene. Good, at 7.765.
Yeah, and I also want to point out he did score a goal last week as well from his own box. Yep. Yep, he threw it in, so he's got one goal under his belt this year.
When you're Will the Wall, you can do anything as he leads the MASL in save percentages. As we keep scrolling through, MASL Player of the Week was Leo Gibson. He did pick up that award after a, hate to say this, an outstanding performance against the Rochester Lancers. Six goals, one assist for Leo Gibson in that game. As we look at some of the highlights, Leo, 7 points in week 10. Kansas City Idol this week. They'll welcome the Harrisburg Heat on February the 6th as we look at the wave of blue turf taking over in the MASL. Well, here, St. Louis leading Rochester's by a score of 7-3. You know, it's a tough one for the Lancers, tough one for the fans. You see them making progress. gap opens up again. St. Louis with a four-goal lead.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think the key thing for Rochester to stay focused on this half is to apply pressure in that attacking half of the field. You see when you attack Paolo there as well as the other St. Louis players, they're going to give up a few balls, and then we've capitalized. However, same's got to stay true for Rochester because St. Louis knows how to make you pay.
A very talented team as we begin fourth quarter. I'd like to just pass along a quick update. We were told that the player for St. Louis, number 86, Otamea is the correct pronunciation. I apologize. I was looking at the pronunciation guide provided by St. Louis, and, you know, my reading, I guess, is not the best. O-I-T-O-E, and then really stressed, M-E-E, ma. So I guess we live and learn. Otamea is what we'll go with, I guess.
I still give you credit for all the pronunciations of these guys. I mean, you did your homework.
Well, Otamea, either way, he's having a big night.
Say, he's having a night.
He's got two goals, one assist on the evening, no matter how you pronounce it or break it down.
Absolutely.
All right, we'll begin the third quarter.
As we look at that bicycle kick once again. We can't get enough of it here in Rochester. Oh, that's just pretty. That's textbook.
All right, Lancers going from right to left. Siliberto, Lanco, Cunningham, Crawford, Rieger.
And let the power play begin.
Should be about 157 left in the man advantage?
I believe so. Granted, I did not go to school for math, so.
Well, you saw my reading skills, not the best. Crawford back to Wilkin. It's Lancers on the man advantage, but St. Louis applying the pressure.
St. Louis doing a very good job keeping that ball in the corner.
Cunningham finally escapes. Going to make a call on that. Cunningham wanted to play on there.
I think a little advantage would have been nice there, but you get the call.
Felipe called for the foul.
Breakout here.
Lanco.
St. Louis did a really good job the first power play that Rochester had, and they're starting off right where they left off at that point.
Lanco played at MCC here in Rochester and Brockport State College. Just outside of the city. Also spent some time with the Lancers NPSL team. Rieger, dangerous spot here.
That should be a pass back.
Yes. That's going to come to the top of the arc. Paolo almost kind of took it off his player's foot. That's strange.
I think he was screaming for it. And
restart, man advantage. Cunningham.
Oh, great block.
Great block. Two players sacrificing. 58 seconds left.
That's well done from St. Louis, just throwing their body at the ball.
Good ball. Siliberto turns off the chest of Paolo.
Good turn. Good save.
40 seconds left. Crawford. Lanco. No one there for Rochester all the way back downfield. Here's Lanco. Deep into the corner, Siliberto.
Good fight.
Rieger joins the battle. 15 seconds left. Picked up. Pablo. Crawford takes him down. Right at midfield, restart coming up for the ambush. Next game for the Lancers, Saturday, February 8th, visiting the Baltimore Blast. For St. Louis, February 8th, Harrisburg comes to town. They'll be honoring the 25th anniversary of their 1995 NPSL Championship. Should be a great night in St. Louis as the Harrisburg Heat come to town. Lancers coming down on the near side. Taken away, sent to Pablo. Santos to St. Louis. Pablo. Who's this guy?
Joey.
Soccer Sam.
Wow, that was
Stealth.
A long, that was a long halftime. They got me working double time.
Stealth, I didn't even know you were here. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. What a great first half for both teams, and I know a lot of people are watching St. Louis. Brian Roth and his group. Brian Roth is the guy that trained us when he was with Kansas City, taught us the ropes, taught us how to sell tickets, sponsorship, and now he's helping the Ambush, and he's there having a big party with the people in St. Louis. I love it.
Yeah, they're at the Post Sports Bar, just a few miles from the Family Arena in St. Louis. 7-3, Sam Lancers had it at 4-3. Great goals. Another chance and a shot and a goal from Otamea.
You can just see the confidence that he has on the ball. Once again, taking that extra touch away from the defender and finding the top of the net.
2:55, and we've called that name a lot. Otamea has got another one on the evening, so he picks up his hat trick. 3 goals, 1 assist for him. Deduca gets the assist. He's just so calm and cool with the ball.
Watch that touch right there. Good fake, roll over, and just roofs it. That's a fantastic indoor goal.
Fourth of the season for Otamea. Lancers trailing 8-3. Play to Rosano. Now Rafa. Sam, great crowd tonight. Awesome cause. Breast cancer awareness, a local family. Really going through some tough times, and you guys have stepped in and just a tremendous opportunity to give back.
Yeah, the Tiding family, and then we do a lot with the Breast Cancer Coalition of Rochester and the jerseys. These same game worn jerseys will be raffled off tonight, and a lot of people are waiting to bid on them. It's going to be fun.
Well, here we've got 11:25 left in the third quarter. Lancers trailing 8-3. Rafa onto something. His shot.
Another
block.
St. Louis is really throwing their bodies at those balls. You can see the teamwork when we get an open shot. St. Louis is right there.
Diego's having trouble with that stretch of turf. That's the second time.
Man rush.
But the Lancers will come back on the counter. Rafa, the shot. Rosano was tripped up. No call made. Pablo. He's taken down by Harling. It's Deduca. Some of these teams, Diesel, Deduca. Let's look at the Otamea goal.
I mean, upper corner, that's how you got to shoot indoor, man. It's just impossible to save. And unfortunately, we're hitting the ball low, and it's just getting blocked by defenders or hitting the goalie. And we're learning, though, slowly. But that Frankie Chilaberto goal, what a goal.
Breathtaking.
If we don't see that on ESPN, something's wrong. Sensational. You could just feel the buzz in the building after Frankie put that one in. Good ball from San Luis.
Watch that back post.
And I am not sure if Dos Santos got it, but it's Jahic who put it across. Looks like he's the one celebrating. We'll put him down in pencil for now, as that's the 9th one for St. Louis this evening. 4:36 time of the goal. And Jahic.
I tell
you. First of the season for him.
Everton, he's put together such an amazing team over the years. And, you know, I think Harrisburg and St. Louis are the two underrated teams in this league. So much firepower, so much talent, and two great coaches. So I like to see what happens there with the Harrisburg and St. Louis. Just so much talent, and you can see it tonight. I mean, they kind of like they start off a little slow, but there's so much from the goalkeeper to Tony. I love Walls up top. They just have so much talent.
Well, Sammy, John and I were looking at the standings in the East. Top four teams will advance to the playoffs. Kind of getting to be a logjam there. And St. Louis not even up there just yet. So it's going to be a wild finish.
Definitely. Next weekend, they host the Harrisburg Heat in St. Louis.
Look
so
at
hopefully
it.
Something happens with that. But, yeah, look at that. I mean, Rochester, I mean, let's pretend we're like on CNN or Fox, right? Right now, the lowest team is the first place team, right? It's like you say they're last place, I say they're first place. It's so confusing right now what's going on in the world of news and media. So we'll just mix it around a little bit.
We call it the spin, Sammy.
Yeah, a little spin.
It's the spin room.
Like right now, we are undefeated. The Lancers are undefeated.
I like it. I like the sounds of that. Into the corner, Scharf. And, Sam, so many players coming in and out, and you could just see these teams Rosano gets a little talking to and a little chest bump with Duarte. Referee will split it up. The players from Orlando moving. Milwaukee making some trades, sending a few guys here. Everyone really starting to gear up for that stretch run.
Yep, it's getting tough out there. I'm a big fan of St. Louis, though, and Shelley does an amazing job as the owner there, one of the owners there.
What a nice tribute. Mm-hmm. Bringing her out and acknowledging the opposition owner. Very nice, Sammy.
She's been so good to us, and she was one of the people that voted for us to come back in the league, you know, despite the situation with the smaller arena and everything else, and she allowed it to happen. So we owe her a lot, and her and Tommy Tanner helped with the schedule, helped Jeff with the schedule. They were working like 2, 3 in the morning to get the schedule done early in the year, and she didn't have to do that. It's all volunteer basis. She did a great job, so that's why we pay tribute to Shelly. But tonight's a special night with the pink jersey and all that. And I see even Johnny One Arm's got the pink jersey on.
Absolutely, always supporting. It's a great cause. And
Rosano. Oh, he's just diving. Is he okay? He's going to serve another 5 minutes. And he's going to want to keep his cool. I think he's a little frustrated.
Understandably so, a little frustration. But Rochester needs to remember, yes, it's 9-3, but there's still a lot of soccer left to be played here.
Joel, can we show that replay again just to make sure Anthony's okay?
Yeah, let's make sure he's okay. He's been watching like Italian City A. Looks like Italian City A soccer
more.
There.
Like, give him about a 7 on that.
I looked at Adam Schwartz, and he just had his hand covering his mouth.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I just think, last night and tonight, some of the calls, come on, let the guys play. This is not outdoor soccer. Let them just play the game.
All right, 9:07 left. Gary Boughton's got a 5-minute break. Santos. So Gary's got his second yellow of the night, I believe, isn't it?
Rosano second.
Rosano. That's
Rosano second.
Rosano, not Gary. My apologies to the farewell tour.
See, Johnny One Arm, though, man, dude, you He's forget good. About working the casino. It ain't going to happen. You got a gig here now.
Hey. Granted, I'd rather be down on the field, but this is the second best thing.
He is good. He knows what he's doing. Knows how to correct the old man. It's Rosano in the box. For 5 more minutes, that'll come out of his paycheck this week. Oitamea. Still Oitamea.
Great defense.
Good job by Crawford. Good positioning, helping out his keeper. 8:18 left. Lancers in Baltimore next week. Gonna do it up again with the Blast. St. Louis home against the Harrisburg Heat. Celebration, Sam.
Great challenge from
they're just calling.
That's
everything.
A questionable call.
So many questionable calls. Again, these guys are buying. They're letting these guys just play with them. And it's throughout the league. It's just sad that these referees, you know, they're too busy talking to each other instead of like focusing on the game.
It's Penso, the official there, who helps with the call, makes the call on the foul. Thomas. That's a good step. That's a good solid step. And it leads to a goal. It's heartbreaking, but it's Walls who puts it in, and he picks up his 16th of the season. But you go back to the call, and it's so frustrating.
Yeah, you can definitely see. I mean, the ref's got a good position on it, and you can see that Ortiz gets a touch on the ball. And just because the player goes down, as long as you get a touch on the ball first, it's all fair game.
10-3 now on Walls' 16th of the season. And again, that's off of a restart.
You can look how St. Louis moves that ball. That's just picture perfect, just moving it around the arc, making Rochester move and find those openings.
Great coaching there. And Tony, I love Walls, man. Leading scorer of the team. He's leaving for Pittsburgh to go play for Bob Lilly. And Bob's such an amazing man, amazing coach. And he's got a career outdoor and indoor in soccer. So I'm happy for Tony Walls. And It's unfortunate. We seem like we were in this game for a while.
Yeah,
but,
we were 4-3. We were there.
It seems like the third and fourth quarter, after halftime, we something clicks off, and we struggle after halftime every game.
But having said that, we've talked so many times where the Lancers have made mistakes and the opposition has made them pay the price. 3 goals tonight. Opposition made a mistake. We went the other way.
Definitely. Yeah, we're going to work on that. Doug's been working hard on it. He's talking to these guys. You know, John, you're part of the practices. You're part of the speeches. I mean, he's such a great technical coach, but he can't prevent if they're in the game and they freeze or they get excited or they got an open shot and they miss. But we were up a man a few times. We couldn't score. And it's growing pains, but it's going to come. But when you see a guy like Frankie Sanfilippo score a goal like that, a local kid, that's my dream, is to have a local team. Most teams have players from other cities that are local players but are playing in other cities. My dream was to have players from Rochester, New York, playing for their home team. And it's going to take a little time, and we knew that. But give us a couple years, and things are going to be much better.
You know who has the same dream? The man to your right. It's exactly what he told me tonight. He wants to be here for the next couple of years to see this thing through and be a part of the club. So, John, let's hope that's a reality for you.
Absolutely, and it's just you can see the layers are coming. They're building on top of each other here.
Paolo's got to be aware as that one was let come through. Sam, how many raffle baskets did you put your little tickets in?
I did $40 worth.
Beautiful.
What is that? I don't know how many
beautiful
that is.
That's 52 tickets.
There you go. I'm really bad at math. But, yeah, I did 52 tickets, and I hope I win so I could maybe donate the basket to the family. So it'd be cool.
How nice.
Well, listen, guys, I got to go get ready for the next part of my job here. You guys are doing a great job. Enjoy the rest of the match.
All right, my friend. Thank you very much, Soccer Sam. Always up, down, in, out. Never stops.
It's a good look from Diego to find
Rafa. Rafa with the rock off the wall. San Luis under pressure. Shove from Lanco. Referee will make that call all day. And a restart coming up here for St. Louis. 6:51 left in the third quarter. 10-3, St. Louis on the lead here. San Luis. Santos.
You can see how technical St. Louis is. All the futsal experience on the team.
Toe poke into the net. He made a great point about Otomea, though. That what do you call it, a little drag? That quick little drag to one side or the other?
Yeah, it's just that shot fake, get your defender moving, and then just roll it back across your body. And that's a deadly, deadly skill in the indoor game. It might not be that deadly in the outdoor game. However, indoor, any form of, you know, break between the players.
Yeah, any little space is what he has done very well tonight. Kozakov. Top of the arc, Duarte. Nope, Cunningham gets there first. Boughton hard challenge, will play on. Cunningham, good battle, pushing him wide! And it's just underneath Wilkin. Kozakov with the goal. 11-3 now for the ambush. Kozakov, his fourth of the season, second of the game.
And I think that's one Brian might want back.
Absolutely.
Now he's played a great game, made some fantastic saves, and I'll never be critical of a goalkeeper. I never will, just because I know the feeling. As we take a look here, that's great strength. Great strength to hold Cunningham off.
Vadim Kozakov has his second of the night, fourth of the year, 9:03. Time of the 11th goal from St. Louis. Molanski. All the way back now to Diego Mayanga. He wants the help of Wilkin, keeps him out of his goal, and gets it to him.
Unlucky touch from Brian. Take a look again here.
Yeah, I definitely want to take a good look at that one.
Yeah.
In the corner. No trouble there for Wilkin.
Quick break out here.
Blanco's got two players closing him down. Back to Paolo.
So he had three Lancers right there, and Paolo just held the ball. Great movement from St. Louis. Great tackle.
Oh, Rafa just couldn't get it a little too far. Quick restart. Now we're going the other way. Bobadilla. That's the thing. You think you get a chance down there, all of a sudden, 2 seconds later, no, you're defending.
Absolutely, and that's one of the fun things, I believe, about indoor soccer is that it's just going back and forth, back and forth.
Absolutely crazy. 4:39 left. 11-3, St. Louis with the lead. Ortiz has a goal tonight. He's looking for his teammate D'Amico on the far side. Rieger's shot. Comes back in front. Bobadilla knocked off the ball. Paolo will scoop it up and keep possession for the ambush. Two other games tonight in the MASL. Mesquite taking on Florida. Ontario versus Sonora. Santos slowly will walk it forward. He'll play it to Dos Santos. Now to San Luis. To Mea. Nice pass into the corner. And Otamea just starting to rack up the points tonight as it's Thomas with the goal this time. 12-3 St. Louis. This is getting ugly.
Yeah, credit to St. Louis, first of all. I mean, St. Louis is moving the ball around. They're showing their experience. They're showing that they've got veteran players on their team that know how to play this game. And they're making Rochester pay.
16th goal of the year for Thomas, and there's that move again.
That
we talked about it.
Yep. And it draws a couple defenders in. Leaves Thomas open on the side there, and he slots it.
11:08, time of the goal. Otamea, 3 goals, 2 assists on the night. Thomas, that's his 16th of the year, and look at this giveaway. Ay, ay, ay. That is not a good one. Jahich. Wow. That'll be unassisted on the mistake from Harling at 11:20. And well, you can watch it and just see what you think about that one. 13-3.
It's tough because, you know, I've been in that situation before down there where things might not be going your way. It's frustrating. The thing that you have to remember is that there's still about a quarter and a half left to play. You got to forget about everything that's happened before and focus on moving forward. We're talking about those layers. You just got to keep building on the good things and the positive things.
The wheels have fallen off, and Lancers need to get back into the shop and try to tighten things up just a little bit to finish this off.
Yeah, and one of my favorite, you know, quotes or sayings that I had for my bio this year is that mistakes are just another word for experience. Take what you can and learn from that. And that's what was expected of us this season. You hear Soccer Sam talking about it. It's the growing pains. This is only going to make us stronger.
St. Louis with Otamea coming forward. Good save from Wilkins, still working hard. Pushes this one up into the corner netting. Restart quickly taking the shot. That's off the crossbar. Otamea.
Oh, too many men on the field,
went
maybe?
Went for the side volley. Yeah, they're pointing towards the bench. Lancers will catch a breather here. 2:45 left.
That was lucky there because I don't know if Rochester had enough defenders on the field.
Yep, good call, John. Too many men on the field. Bobadilla will serve it. 12:15 time of this penalty. Lancers on the man advantage.
Take a look at it here. And here Rochester had 3 defenders. That was a great start from St. Louis.
Tough to tell from that angle how many players were in the backside of that shot.
Right. But I think even St. Louis was a little surprised on how quick.
If you could freeze it right. Too quick for my old eyes.
But
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and there must have been another one somewhere else.
Yeah,
the referees were quick on the call.
St. Louis took that quickly, and I think that surprised them as well. It was smart by St. Louis, though, because Rochester only had 3 defenders in the box. So they definitely had the advantage. It was just a little too quick.
Timing was just a little off. Lancers on the power play.
So it's time to build off that power play and get a little momentum back here.
Rieger. Blanco, good shot. Cunningham, what a
great
shot.
Great save.
And a great save from Paolo.
Wow.
Mayanga. Cunningham, good
shot.
Another
great save.
How he saw that one, I do not know. traffic in front, got a hand on it still.
Paolo, my gloves are off to you, my friend, as a fellow goalie. Those are two world-class saves.
Cunningham looking for more. Little fake, goes back to Mayanga. Blanco. Heavy touch from Mayanga, given away. And foul there on Cunningham along the near side boards. He'll slow things down and give Rochester a chance to regroup defensively.
Just take a look at these. This save right here, that's point blank. I know how it feels to take a shot from Cunningham. Great pressure from Diego.
Good ball, Siliberto couldn't get his second. A great slide tackle.
Well done by St. Louis, once again throwing their body in front of the ball.
Pablo Da Silva. Walls, nope. Little pickpocket work there from Jeremy Lanco. Just over a minute left here in the third quarter. Lancers down by a bunch. They're going to get some positive vibe off this power play. Lanco, good shot.
It's not a bad effort. You know, when you're down by a little bit, start throwing things at the net. Good things happen.
Good shot from Jeremy Lanco. Under a minute to play, 8 seconds left on the man advantage.
Gotta be careful right now if you're Rochester. Watch that backboard.
Uh-oh.
Yep, there
it is.
Away
to Duca.
That.
Ortiz says, I didn't touch you. Referee says,
now,
yep.
I did see, we'll see on the replay here, from the first view, it did look like Jeremy did get him a little bit. However, it seemed a little embellished.
Here's a look at it, my friend.
Yep, definitely got him. I give DeDuca about a 8 or 9 on the acting meter there after that.
You know
that.
What? These veteran indoor players, like Sam said, they feel a little touch, a little contact, boom.
But you know what? At the same time, that's a fantastic play by DeDuca to do that. I wonder if he didn't do that extra dive there, if they would have gotten even a blue card on it.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a veteran move.
Man advantage for the ambush. Looking for more. Pablo. Go to Mea. Pablo.
Watch that back post.
Back post is there. Ball is off the mark. Thomas.
It's great ball movement once again from St. Louis.
Go to Mea. Loves that touch. Loves that
touch.
He
does. That roll, it's deadly.
Final 6 seconds of the quarter. One more shot here. Otamea punched away nicely by Wilkin as we bring third quarter to a close. 6 goals given up by the Lancers in that quarter. A tough one.
I just say let's forget about the third and let's move on. That's all I got to say about that.
All right. Lancers Broadcast Network will be back with fourth quarter action.
series. It's Scott Cordero.
Hey y'all, let me show you the absolute best training tool that I've ever experienced. It's called Rio Ball. I discovered Rio Ball while training with a professional team in Brazil. I had a ton of fun and my touch had never been so sharp. This spring, be the first to find your Rio Ball advantage. Sign up at RioBall.com today and receive 20% off your first order.
Order, Oitomia. 3 goals, 2 assists for Oitomia tonight as we begin the fourth quarter. All right, Lanco, D'Amico, Rieger, and Wolanski on the penalty kill. Ortiz in the box. 15 minutes left here, fourth quarter. As we'll hopefully play more than 5 minutes. Shows on the clock right now.
Yep.
All right. Underway now. Fourth quarter. Have to look back at the stats from the season, but it may be the most goals the Lancers have given up in a quarter.
And if it is, I would like to keep that stat quiet.
Oitomia with one. Jahic, Walls, Kozakov, Thomas, and Jahic with another one.
Now, hats off to St. Louis, though, in that third quarter. They are fighting for a playoff position, and they came out hungry, and they came out determined, and they've got a more than a comfortable lead at this point. And now it's just, you know, we might see some substitutions of players that haven't played much.
And they have changed keepers. Jason Norsek has come on. This is only his second appearance of the season. He's given up 6 goals. He's got experience with almost every St. Louis professional indoor soccer club. Going back to the days of the Steamers. Wow, those were some great teams then.
There's a great pressure from Rochester here. Understanding that they are trying to kill a power play here.
Just under a minute left in the Ortiz sin bin time. Pablo, Duduka, back to Pablo. A little tangle there, a little shove as well. Duduka still keeps possession. Knocked away by D'Amico.
I know we were talking about Diesel last night, but Duduka's a big guy as well.
He's a horse.
He is a horse. A monster.
Here is Oitomia. Pablo. Oitomia.
It's a good tip from D'Amico.
Shot wide. Pablo, good move.
Ortiz.
The corner. Duduka. Oh! Cross the goal mouth. Low shot. Good save from Wilkin.
Good save. Good hold. Trying to set the breakout. There goes Jeremy Ortiz.
Double team pressure. Call D'Amico. Oh. Hang on, John. Stay with me, buddy.
I'm staying with you. I'm sorry.
Stay with me.
Staying with you. I might need a little oxygen over here. The
next one, you'll take care of me, all right?
Yeah.
Oi is right. Oitomia.
Oitomia is correct. All right, and the play has resumed here. And
all right, good thing is Ortiz is out of the box. Lancers are back to full strength. Good
kick
save from Wilkin.
Oh,
what a little touch there from Tony Walls.
There goes Rafa.
Lancers coming the other way. A good idea looking for D'Amico. Rafa's shot is off the mark. So Liberto almost got his second.
Rafa took a
hammer in the box.
Good play from Brian right there to come out. Rafa's still chirping away, and I don't blame him one bit.
Big reaction from the Lancers bench. Just saw him take a tumble. Ortiz's shot is blocked. Here's Norsic. Gets a touch outside. Gives it to Godoy.
Wide open.
In front. Frankie's got his second. Lancers making St. Louis pay.
And that fired Rafa up. I do understand that it's 13-4, but that's a big, big goal. You're coming out and you're playing this quarter like it's a new game. Go out and try and win this quarter. Get going for the road trip next week.
Well, Frankie's got two on the night, three on the year. One goal, or two goals, one assist. Three-point night for Frankie Siliberto.
It's a big game from Frankie here. At halftime, we heard his high school coaches were here and friends and family, and just look at that. Rafa sets it up. Great pressure from Rochester once again.
What a mistake from the keeper, and he paid the price. Sharp leaving it there for Duarte. Thomas. Or Santos, sorry. Jahic. Sharp's ball across the middle, taken away by Lanco. Lanco. Still Lanco. Battling there. Rosano helping out as well. Check that. It's Osmic. I think it's his
Osmic,
first shift
yep.
of the night.
First shift of the night for him. Look at that goal once again. Bad giveaway and right there. That fired Rafa up.
I think Everton's going to have a word with Norsic.
Yes, but in his defense, it is only his second appearance yeah. of the season, so that's expected when you don't play much. I mean, you saw how Paolo played this whole game and this whole season, and you know, it's going to happen. Yep. It's going to happen.
Seen it both ways. Ortiz will step in, rifles Ooh. One. Not too far off the mark. Ooh. Bouton shot is blocked. Still a ball in front and a goal. Jeremy Ortiz with some help from the boy from Buffalo.
The legends, the Wall of Famers.
3:53. Ortiz, second goal of the night.
Great pressure from Rochester.
Bouton will get the helper. Oh, they're going to say D'Amico instead of Bouton. Let's take a look at that one. This could be interesting. Jeremy's going to sign the ball, his third of the year. And some lucky fan's going to go away with that light up soccer ball.
Oh, he's switching fields. And up to the kiddos.
Sneaky man. Let's see who he gives it to. Give it to one of the kids.
Oh, here the Lancers go again.
Another chance. Mayanga. Oh, and another goal. What's going on? Lanco!
Jeremy Lanco, workhorse, getting his first goal. That's fantastic. Look at
seconds.
That.
10 seconds after
firing up
Ortiz.
The crowd. And that forces a timeout from St. Louis. And I don't blame them one bit.
Diego with the assist. His fourth of the year, Lanco's first goal as an indoor Lancer.
Oh my gosh, that's great for him. You talk about workhorses, you talk about the time and effort that he has put into this game. Oh. And,
13-6, I mean, we're having some fun
look
here,
at this,
folks.
Diego, great patience from Diego here to find Jeremy, and I'll be honest, that's not an easy finish either.
No, not at all.
And he's looking, I think, for his daughter.
Well done, Jeremy Lanco. Congratulations.
Yes.
On your first Lancers indoor goal. You know, I think you made a great point. Well-timed break here for St. Louis.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Trying to calm everybody down here. I mean, 13-6 now, and I still understand that's a pretty big deficit, but you keep scoring goals 10 seconds apart.
Oh, and take a look who's coming off the bench.
And Paolo will be going back in nets.
Oh. Got a feel for Norsic.
You do, absolutely. You know, as a goalie, like I mentioned, you never like getting pulled, and I
And you can watch Everton just, he's putting his arms out like, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah.
He got the pull after just 4 minutes and 3 seconds.
But if, you know, his defense, there, he hasn't had much help back there either.
They were definitely in a shambles there.
Yeah, they haven't had much. It just seems like fourth quarter came out and St. Louis was just lackadaisical about it. But Paolo's back in. He's definitely that commander back there, and that's going to get him back on track. Well,
3 goals in a minute, 16 seconds.
As you can see, they get a top of the box play already.
Not a bad start to the quarter.
No. I mean, play each quarter like it's a brand new game, and right now, they're winning this quarter.
Wall shot, deflected wide. Thomas can't get any juice on that one. Ortiz's goal came at 3:53, 4:03, Lanco. 10 seconds later, three-line pass.
Three-line pass there. And we've talked about St. Louis and how they've been in some nail biters.
See, maybe they want to get it closer.
I was going to say, they know. I think they have that bug.
It's getting fun.
It is. Just a little worried after that third quarter, but, you know.
Cunningham and a goal!
It's tee time. Michael Cunningham rips it bottom corner.
Woo-hoo. Fourth goal of the quarter.
They're having some fun down there.
Second of the game for Michael. Fifth of the year. I love it. Tee time.
They go out with the tee time. Cunningham, like we said, maybe one goal just opens up the floodgates for him, and he's had three or four fantastic chances, and Paolo's come to the task as well.
34 seconds, 3 goals. Unbelievable.
It's a great free kick.
Wow. Well taken, Mr. Cunningham.
There you go. Pressure's back on. That's great work from St. Louis. Open it up, and here we go.
Jahic, he scores.
I'm saying, calm down. We're still here. But, you know what, that's great ball movement from St. Louis, and that's a very good finish. Very good finish.
It's a hat trick for Jahic, third of the year, third of the game. 3 goals, 1 assist.
Jahic, I give credit to him. That was, you know, great patience. Made a little fake, had Brian go down, and just placed it to the corner netting there. Take a look at it. A little timing there makes that a little fake. And
helper there was Santos. The Lancers can get that energy back. Foul call.
Now, I believe, is this the most goals that the Lancers have had this season?
Let's take a look,
I
my friend.
I believe it is, but I'm not 100% sure here.
Lanco, the goal scorer, dumped. Restart for the Lancers in a pretty decent spot.
Yeah, about right where Cunningham had the free kick there. And you got Jeremy open on the
tease.
Oh, that's good.
Lanco. Quick spin there, just couldn't get it.
Be a goal throw here.
There's the breakout and the goal from Jahic.
That's a great finish.
Oito Mia.
I think he got his little ponytail pulled there and was a little mad about it.
Wanted a call, did not get it. Santos, good ball for Dos Santos. Bobadilla dribbles around the keeper. Wilkin with a little topo.
Great play from Brian. Pressure's not done yet, though. And here goes Rochester. And St. Louis wins it back.
Yep. Most goals scored by the Lancers this season. 5 against the Harrisburg Heat. December 27.
Brian's down hurt right now.
Marcelo Moreira is the backup keeper.
Looks like he's getting his stuff right. I don't know if just an extension here.
Let's take a look at it. Ooh.
Oof.
That right ankle, it looks like that kind of landed awkward. You can see him just in pain right there. Great look by Joel and the crew at Varsity Media. We do not need another goalie injury. I've got one next to me up here with the shoulder. Wilkin looks like he's holding his arm, actually.
Let's take another look at it here.
Oh, is it the knee?
I don't know if he just, I can't tell.
Looks like it's the right arm that's being held by Marcelo Moreira.
I don't know if it's the arm or if it's the hand.
Will be coming on. The 45-year-old actually played 10 games with St. Louis during 2015 and 16. I think it's the right knee or right ankle.
Can we possibly rewind that a little bit? Yep, right there, and then just we'll play it. I wonder if it's when he put his hand out to stretch. I don't know who the St. Louis player was. Maybe grabbed it a little bit and pulled it, and I'm having flashbacks.
I was going to say,
the trainer came out, held my arm like that, it was my shoulder. Oh. So, you know, I pray that it's nothing too serious. I mean, he's been a wall back there for Rochester. He's been a game changer, and it's just been, you know, I hate to see any goalie get hurt.
Let's hope nothing serious. Brian Wilkin, nothing but hopefully a speedy recovery and just a little bruise. It's Marcelo Moreira.
It's a good save from
Paolo.
He
is in the nets for Rochester. Does everything and anything for goalkeepers here in the Rochester area, whether it's youth, collegiate, outstanding keeper, outstanding person as well.
Absolutely.
Comes up with a kick save.
Good touch from St. Louis. I can't tell who that is. Pablo, I think.
Bobadilla. Looking to Oitomia.
Oh, what
shot!
A finish.
Oh, and it rifles under the crossbar.
Oitomia
and
with a
Min.
Oh, that's a great finish.
Oitomia having a night here in Rochester. 4 goals, 2 assists.
Wow.
Making a strong case for player of the week. 6:46 time of his fourth of the evening.
Just take a look at that and just that one touch and crossbar and in. Tamia is
Bobadilla with the assist.
Having a night.
15-7. Lancers have surpassed their highest goal-scoring total. Did it twice, 5 goals.
Which is, it's a positive. It's definitely a positive. It's great pressure once again.
Or check that one time against Harrisburg, 10-5 loss. As far as goals against, they've given up 15 tonight. The most they've surrendered is 17, a 17-4 loss to the Florida Tropics. Midway through the fourth quarter. This one's too heavy, coming back out to the arc. D'Amico's header up and into the crowd. And this will be our media timeout, 15-7. St. Louis leading on the Lancers Broadcast Network. Final push here in the fourth quarter. St. Louis on the restart. Oito Mia. Felipe. 7:08 left. Oito Mia. Otamia. Pablo. It's a back. Looking for Otamia. Here's Oito Mia. The shot! Good save.
Great
from
save.
Marcelo. Keeps it out.
Another
good save, Marcelo.
Wow, well done, Marcelo.
Gets a round of applause from the fans behind the net. And the veteran coming up big on two situations. He'll heave one downfield. Santos will put it back towards the Brazilian. Crawford, that's a dangerous ball. Good job by Marcelo to hurry up. Ortiz. Good ball, Cunningham. D'Amico. Crawford. Paulo, who had a little break here for 4 minutes and 27 seconds. Ortiz is dunked by Jahic. Jahic, well, gets his first goals of the season, and he gets three of them. Player who joined the ambush on New Year's Day, 2020. His pass is intercepted to Jahic. Toe poke off the boards. Almost got his own rebound.
We'll try and get an update on Brian here when we can. I do see the trainer did come back out, so that's a positive sign. Wasn't in there that long. At least I hope it's a positive sign.
Let's hope it's nothing too serious.
I hope it's a positive sign. I'm trying to get an update.
You guys have both been outstanding this year, and it's the last thing this club needs. Santos. Duarte.
Oh.
Off the hands of unlucky. Marcelo Moreira, and Duarte makes it 16-7.
Duarte with a rocket of a shot. A rocket of a shot.
9:23 time of Duarte's goal. And for Mr. Duarte, second of the season.
Well, we're looking at it by quarters. It's 4-3 Rochester right now. However, playing by quarters doesn't really matter that much.
...16-7, Lancers trailing this one.
Great play from Pablo coming out on that. I think there's a talk of maybe a handball or... So, update for Brian Wilkin here. Hyperextended his thumb. So it's not as serious as we thought it was, but you know, well wishes, and I hope you get back soon.
Yeah, nothing but the best, my friend. Thanks to Mark Satilli for that update. The legend, the American dream, the mechanic, whatever else you need to say. 3-on-1 here for Rieger. Rieger.
Oh, great play.
Good save. Silberto denied the hat trick.
I know we got a lot of nicknames for him. Our favorite nickname for the goalies at practice is Dad. He is our dad at practice. He is a fantastic guy, very knowledgeable, and keeps us in line.
Played high school soccer with Mr. Satilli. He just doesn't stop.
Well, Sam, I'm sure you got some stories.
San Luis shot. Nice save from Marcelo.
Great save from Marcelo.
Oh, yeah, stories and then some. Mark loves the game, a great goalkeeper, and now giving back as a coach.
So I think I was reading for the Wall of Fame that he actually showed up for the Lancers to try out as a Lancer Louie. And then Sam said, no, you're not going to be the mascot. You're going to go play for me.
Always had cat-like reflexes. Great man on and off the field, Mark Satilli.
Absolutely.
Just a shade over 4 minutes left. St. Louis with 16, Rochester with 7. Good shoulder challenge from Mayanga.
Oh, legs got tangled up there.
Jeremy Ortiz down by Walls.
Rochester.
Bouton. Good step over.
No,
nobody on
there.
The end. Crawford, toe poke. Paolo knows the angle so well.
He does, and that's the veteran presence in him. He's playing an outstanding game tonight.
No call. Walls was fouled. Play back to Paolo. 3.5 left. St. Louis looking to get to 7-8. Lancers just looking for that first one to break through. With 3 minutes left. Highly unlikely it'll happen here tonight.
I know. But you know what? Credit to Rochester for not giving up here.
Blanco. Shot to the far side wide. It's Rafa. Crawford to Boughton. Blanco seeing much more of the field here in this second half. Header, one hop, and Paolo will scoop it up. On to the near side. Good step from Ortiz.
Great step.
Still Ortiz. Boughton, Ortiz, goal!
Well done, boys.
Jeremy Ortiz has the hat trick.
Great ball movement. The veteran experience, Boughton to Ortiz.
Boughton's second assist of the night. Throw the hats on the field for JL. 12-22. Fifth goal of the quarter for the Lancers. Two of those coming from Jeremy Ortiz.
That's a great finish from Jeremy, as we just saw, putting it right out past the outstretched leg of Paolo there.
So happy for Jeremy.
Yes.
Ambassador on the field, off the field.
He works so hard, flies in from Philadelphia for these games. And
he's going to make the fans work hard for this ball.
You better believe it. Take a look at it again here, and just that's a great finish.
Gary Boughton with the helper.
D'Amico, Paolo, well done. Paolo, well done.
Not
my
done
apologies.
Yet, though. D'Amico, good move. Across, cutting him. Oh!
I think it took a deflection, maybe.
It sure looked like it.
It looked like it did, but.
He wanted the hat trick as well. A coming out party for Ortiz and maybe Cunningham as well. He's got two tonight. Just over 2 minutes left. Santos. Wolanski.
Oh, that's well done from Marcelo.
Look at that aggressive
that's
play.
That's great play. It's well done from Z-Man, as we call him.
Boughton. Wolanski. Michael Cunningham. Oh, a good ball.
Good luck.
Looking for Boughton. Marcelo off his line.
The veteran experience there with Marcelo in the back.
Crawford. Ortiz.
Oh, he's not done.
What's more? Why not? Minute 22 left. Lancers down by 8. Siliberto. Siliberto, 2 goals tonight. Cunningham, 2 goals tonight. Ortiz with a hat trick. And Lanco in there as well. Looking for Ortiz.
You know, sometimes you just need that wake-up call, and that can, you know, make things start clicking. And when you get goals like that under your belts, the confidence starts to build. Rochester is going to be a team that could play spoiler, and I believe will play spoiler in the upcoming games here.
Crawford, one-timer, good try. Jeremy Ortiz on that goal just a couple minutes ago. Beautifully placed. Nowhere else he could have put it. Just inside that far post. And then tucked in to the backside.
Oh, it's a great ball.
54 seconds left. Marcelo to Mayanga. 44 seconds left. Mayanga under pressure. Harlan gets away from one, gets away from two, gets away from three. Siliberto, hat trick. Oh, unselfish. He'll have the shot now.
Oh, great save. Nice. Fantastic save.
Paolo hanging in midair.
You know, Harling was wanting the ball back. Great run from Harling, but fantastic save from Paolo there.
And a great run, like you said, from Alex.
As I say, you can make the argument here that Otemeu is the man of the match for St. Louis, but I believe Paolo, some of those saves he doesn't make, the game's different.
Yeah, he was outstanding tonight, without a doubt. Oitamea, and Oitamayu, however you want to say it, had a good game, but Paolo as well. But for the Lancers, highest offensive output of the season, 8 goals, and, you know, opposition made some mistakes. Lancers made them pay. Some standouts, Ortiz with a hat trick, Frankie Siliberto with the goal of the year. That's what I'm going to call it.
Absolutely.
And Michael Cunningham, tee time is on.
Absolutely, and this is something that they can build off of going on the road trip next week. You know, a forgettable third quarter, if I do say so, but yeah, you know what, come back in the fourth and lit it up.
We're going to go down to field level for our post-game interviews with Soccer Sam. Lancers, after this result, still winless after 13, while St. Louis now goes to 7-8. Let's go to Soccer Sam on the field.
Soccer Sam.
Thank you, Rocky Parada. Tonight we're talking to two Jeremys. First time in our new history that we've scored 8 goals. Jeremy Ortiz, hat trick, yes?
I believe so, hat trick, yeah.
Hat trick, congratulations on a hat trick today. Great game, Jeremy Ortiz, for you.
Yeah, I appreciate it. And fans, you know, keep coming out to these games. I know, you know, this year hasn't been the way we wanted to, but, you know, we got a young squad. These guys are energetic, passionate, and optimistic. And sooner rather than later, things are going to start clicking. And I'm glad I'm a part of this group, and I'm just trying to pass down my wisdom. So, fans, one more time, thank you so much for still coming out and supporting us. We appreciate it.
And, Jeremy, this game-worn jersey, it's a little wet right now, but you could go up there at the Goal Kick Lounge and bid on this jersey where all the money goes to the Breast Cancer Coalition of Rochester.
Yes, please, if you guys come up to the stands after the game. You know, it's breast cancer awareness, and, you know, I'm sorry I'm out of breath right now, playing hard, so just come out and support the breast cancer. And let's go, everyone. Come
on. Hey, you didn't like vape when you were a kid or anything, did you?
No, just put it in that work. Just put it in that work. But like I said, come on, fans, come on out and support the cause.
Thank you. Jeremy Ortiz, hat trick tonight. Jeremy Lanco, the way you celebrated tonight, baby, first professional goal playing for your Lancers. I love that bow and arrow thing, Jeremy Lanco.
Yeah, my brother-in-law, he's a big hockey guy, and that's a big hockey celebration. Hockey's big with us, so I kind of pulled that one out of the hat. I've got a lot of family here tonight. I was just happy to see them and perform for them and the fans and the coaching staff who pushes us so hard and demands a lot, and it felt good to get the monkey off my back for that.
Well, you're playing hard at practice. You got a great shot, Jeremy. You do so much for this team on and off the field. You play for our NPSL team. We really appreciate all you do for this club.
Hey, I love it. I'm a Rochester guy. It's all worth it, man. It's fun. I appreciate you. I appreciate everybody here, and thanks for everybody being here.
All right, Jeremy Lanco, first professional goal. Thank you so much, Jeremy. We're now going to go to the head coach of the St. Louis Ambush, Everton. Everton, you almost came to Rochester as a player a few years back. Rich Randall had you. We were talking, remember, back at the Blue Cross Arena. But you went on to being a superstar player and now coach in this league. Amazing job tonight with your team.
Now, first of all, you guys are doing a great job in here. The atmosphere that you guys bring to the game is amazing. I almost came here, and I always love to come back to the city, to see you guys, you know, seeing so many friends. Like Jeremy Ortiz, he was my rookie in Philadelphia back when I was playing there. So it's great to see you guys. You guys bringing something special here.
Well, your team tonight looked fantastic. I talked about it on the broadcast. I think you and Harrisburg are the two underdogs in this league. You guys got something special, and you guys meet up Saturday in St. Louis.
It's going to be a great game. We know some of their players because I had them in my roster like a couple of years ago. Um, they they've been playing amazing. I was watching last night game against Tacoma. They had a tremendous game, and we've been preparing ourselves as well. The game's going to be at home, so we're going to bring a lot of intensity. So it's going to be a good game, great for the fans to come and watch it.
Well, thank you so much for you do for this game and the St. Louis Ambush, man. You turned this baby around. I think you could be the coach of the year, man, the way you've turned this team around.
No, thank you so much. My focus is to go to playoffs. Coach of the year is a secondary plan or, you know, into the third place plan. But I just want to say I'm extremely glad that you are back to the indoor soccer. We missed you, and I really hope that we stick around for a long, long, long time.
All right, Everton, the head coach of the St. Louis Ambush, congratulations on a big victory tonight. Go talk to your team. Back up to you guys, Joe and Johnny One Arm. Thank you so much. Take it away, guys.
All right, Soccer Sam, thank you very much. Johnny One Arm has gone away to the jersey auction, so he will be auctioning off his number 31 jersey this evening. Everton, Tony Donatelli last night, just wonderful words for the organization here in Rochester. Can't thank those guys enough. First-class individuals, winning or losing, whether they come to Rochester or not. Final score tonight, 16-8. St. Louis with the win. Rochester looking for their first win, 0-13 on the season, while St. Louis goes to 7-8. Lancers back home on February 21st. For our entire production crew, Joel, our producer at Varsity Media, John Savaglia, and Soccer Sam, Joe Giuliano saying so long from the Dome Arena.